Welcome back to our SAP Enablement Series. My name is Stefan Müller and I am glad to introduce you today to the basics how to use the Qlik SAP Extractor Connector. For those who are new to our SAP video sessions, I like to start with a short explanation what the SAP Connector is all about. The Qlik SAP Connector provides you with a set of 9 SAP certified connectors to digest data in Qlik Sense from all default SAP interfaces, regardless if you run SAP ERP, BW or HANA. In addition to the actual data extraction, the product also supports the transfer of SAP security definitions and can consider SAP internal routines. And as Qlik Sense is by default capable of consolidating data from different sources, SAP data can, of course, be combined with non-SAP data. Okay, let's assume we convinced you to use our SAP connector in your SAP landscape and you are interested in a more detailed enablement of the SAP Extractor connector. Great! That's exactly what I'm focusing on in my today's video session. Let's start with a short overview where the extractor can be used on a SAP ERP system. Well, for sure, it can retrieve datasets from SAP extractors, the layer which provides generic and customized business content for SAP BW. In addition, it is capable to load hierarchies, but with some weaknesses. So we recommend the SQL connector in this case instead. See my SAP enablement video covering the SQL connector bonus content for more details. Jumping to the SAP BW site and having a look on the application layer integration there, the extractor connector is first of all able to read data store objects, flat physical tables where historical transactional data is stored and data sets are processed. Second, it can refer to star schema modeled multidimensional datasets in an info cube. Or you can use it to pick and transfer metadata information about dimensions and key figures by querying info objects. Finally, hierarchies in SAPW can also be extracted. As we have talked about the different integration options, we move forward to the prerequisites you have to consider when applying the SAP Extractor connector. The SAP Extractor connector will only work when you properly install and configure the SAP Network Server and open the SAP Client in the relevant SAP system. I addressed this topic in more detail in my video about the setup process of the SAP connector. Please have a look there or refer to the specific links to our online help in the description of this video. Another important issue is to manually set the SAP system gateway ports if the SAP GUI is not locally installed on the Qlik Sense Enterprise server. Are there any other to-dos before loading data into Qlik apps? Yes, there are preparation tasks in SAP. Mainly, you have to create and activate a logical system the extractor connector refers to. Otherwise, the connectivity won't work. Let's have a look in a short demo how these steps are performed. I'm connected to a SAP ERP system running on HANA. Let's use transaction RSA6 to get a list of all standard extractors in SAP ERP. These data sources are mainly used to populate SAPW with business content for analytical purposes. You can display the dataset of a certain extractor. For example, in the context of sales and distribution, the data records of the extractor 2LIS01S260, which represents data records of sales orders. You can double-click on this extractor and the table structure is displayed. But without a logical system, you cannot process this data further. So you have to set up a logical system in the following two steps. Using a Qlik provided transaction called qtqvc/extractor_ADM, we get different maintenance options for logical systems. Here we define the personal extraction space for the count used for connecting Qlik with your SAP system. Let's create a new entry. For example, we choose the name qtqvc smr01 and select the server name for executing the remote function call. In order to proceed now, the SAP client has to possess the appropriate permissions. This is what I mentioned before, the SAP client has to be opened. Or what means the same, the client has to be unlocked to be permitted to create this logical system right now. So the environment has been created successfully. So the next step is to activate this logical system and assign a extractor or extractors to it. For this, we have another Qlik provided transaction. In this case, qtqvc activate. Here we point to the just created logical system and assign the previous explored extractor. In order to find it, we use a search pattern. Because the list of available extractors is quite long. And here we find the one we have investigated before, SD sales order, we select it. We hit get extractor, we get the table structure again. We have to select all fields or all the fields we want to pass the Qlik. And finally, we have to activate the extractor. After completing these preparing steps in SAP, we can now start to create a load script in a Qlik app and retrieve data. We will be supported by a wizard helping us to select all relevant parameters. What is also important to know is that the extractor connector can be configured to do a full or incremental load when the specific SAP extractor allows it. To visualize how to proceed here, I like to demo the load process as well. On my Qlik Sense app, I create a new app and call it SAP Extractor Demo. Open the app and I open the load script editor. In my demo environment, the Qlik SAP Connector package is already installed and certain SAP connections are configured. First of all, I create a new section and call it SAP Extractor. And choose the appropriate connection on the list of data connections on the right-hand side. A wizard pops up and provides me with two drop-down menus. So at first I select the logical system I've created before and I will get a list of all extractors assigned to this logical system. In our case, it is just the sales order extractor. So I can select this extractor and I will get the table structure now on the right-hand side. And what I could do here is to decide if I want to load all fields or only a subset of them, and if I want to provide any filters or conditions for certain fields to reduce the amount of data records. I keep everything by default and hit the Insert Script button. A load statement is generated listing known elements like table fields, table name, and data source. But also some important additional parameters you can modify on demand manually. E.g., you can enable data load options and or store the result that in QVDs. For the demo, I keep the script unchanged and execute it. After a certain period of time, the table is extracted, respectively loaded. Jumping to the data model viewer, I can validate the table setup and amount of records. In my case, I have loaded round about 58,000 rows from the specified SAP extractor and I could now start to visualize the sales order figures. This concludes my contribution in terms of the basics how to use the Qlik SAP Extractor Connector. I hope you found it helpful. In addition to this introductory video, I'm planning to record bonus content about more details of the Qlik SAP Extractor technical design specifications. Inter alia, I will talk about additional useful SAP transactions we provide. So watch out for this release or have a look at any other learning video of our SAP enablement series. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.